The Highlands is the greenbelt to Megalopolis.
A number of people, when I talk about the Highlands, are not quite sure what I mean.
One of New Jersey's best-kept secrets. Rolling hills, forests draped over them.
This was pulled apart probably 250 million years ago, and the mountains are still sitting there.
There is a very, very direct link between the cities and the Highlands, but it's one that most of the people in the cities don't recognize.
The key to understanding the Highlands is its geology. Its defining characteristic is crystalline rock, which has resisted erosion for millions of years.
The Highlands are ancient mountains. They represent just the remnants of some huge mountain system that was probably bigger than the Himalayas at one point. We're talking about huge mountains. We're looking at the roots of them now. Which is amazing because this was pulled apart probably 250 million years ago, and the mountains are still sitting there.
Glacial movement eventually scraped hilltops clean, leaving higher elevations of impervious rock with little soil. Here, water doesn't get absorbed into the ground. It travels through underground cracks in the crystalline rock.
So what we will see then is that the rocks of the Highlands are all crystalline now because they were all... Well, most of New Jersey, southern New Jersey and the Newark Basin, they're made of sedimentary rocks. And sedimentary rocks are composed of cranes that are stuck together. And the way the water then goes through these rocks is to wind its way around the grains that are sitting there. And where it makes contact with the grains, then you can have chemical reactions which remove some of the pollutants from the water. In crystalline rock, it has no natural porosity or permeability. The grains are stuck right together. So you have to have those cracks in order to transmit the water. Well, with a crack, is like an open pipe. It just goes straight through, doesn't make any contact for the chemical reactions, and they're not close enough together to get rid of the bacteria.
With its high peaks and minimal filtration, the Highlands seems an unlikely source for clean water.
It's an absolutely vulnerable region. Anytime they have a spill, a leaky gas tank, a leaky landfill, something like that, it radically impacts the water. And there's been a couple of cases where, when you have those spills, you really destroy the quality of the water in the local area. And because the slopes are relatively steep, the water is actually injected down into the systems around it. And so therefore, the groundwater systems and the surface water systems on all sides of the Highlands are directly and very significantly affected by the quality of water that comes from the Highlands.
Then what made the Highlands a good water source? The answer lies in the forest.
The mountain forests in the northern Highlands are typical of what should be a healthy, vibrant forest that has a very rich native assemblage, from a very intact, large canopy down to a well-developed sub-canopy. When you have a structurally rich forest, as the water falls from the clouds, it's intercepted by the canopy layer, and it may hit that and cascade almost like a ball coming down a series of pinball bumpers down to the forest floor. So it's intercepted, it's slowed down, and then at the bottom, it's gonna reach this very rich, thick duff layer of leaf litter, where it gets absorbed like a sponge.
The forests of the Highlands drop leaves, which create humus layer, and the humus can be as deep as 40, 45 inches in some places and serves as a tremendous sponge which soaks up the water, reduces the speed of the runoff, slowly releases it to the streams, and also filters it going into the groundwater.
They can pull pollutants out of the water and filter it down so that before it gets down into the bedrock, into this fracture system, it gets relatively cleaned up. Otherwise, if it went straight into the fracture system where we didn't have that cover, water quality would be worse in the Highlands than it is in the lowlands.
You can always view forest land as sort of a water farm. Not necessarily that we're farming the forest lands, but we are cultivating them in the sense that they are providing something that's going on underground in terms of filtration. It's sort of a hidden value of forest land.
Studies have shown that forests capture, store, and filter water at a rate 40 times greater than even undeveloped areas like farmlands and grassy parks. Forested headwaters are the cleanest sources within a watershed, especially those located far from human impact.
The stream that may be feeding a reservoir is going to branch out like a root system or like our arteries and capillaries. You have to go out and follow the capillaries and follow the arteries throughout the landscape and protect that on a very large spatial scale in order to adequately protect the catch basin, the reservoirs. You really want this to be within a vast forest itself. It is a very cost-effective water filtration purification system. It's either that or get the world's biggest Brita filter. And there it's currently occurring at no cost to us.